Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in this video, we are going to talk about color correcting. What are the do's, what are the don'ts, what are the mistakes you do, what types of color correcting can you do, how to do everything, like everything related to color correcting, which will, you know, come into my mind. We will talk about it. So yeah, let's get started. Yes, we are supposed to ignore my hair in the entire video, just giving that disclaimer like before starting, because it's monsoon. My hair won't stay in place. It would for a couple more months until the monsoon ends, so you have to be ready to see me with such hair. So on the left side, I'm going to show you what people usually do for color correcting, and on the right side, I'll show you what I do and what I think looks really nice. You know, so I have 4 to 5 types of such things which I want to demonstrate. So I'm going to show you, you know, it on different sections of my face area, and so that you'll at least understand how to do it, what type suits your skin. You can just try all of them and see, you know, see which one actually suits your, you know, skin according to your complexion. Color correcting has various types of it. So the most common type of color correcting is using an orange corrector to cancel out the darkness. There are other types like green for, you know, red, you know, discoloration, then violet for other things, but you know, I don't think those matter so much as color correcting for darkness does, because those are things, you know, if you use a full coverage foundation, they do get covered. But when it is dark area, the kind of the gray peeps through always, so it's always mandatory to color correct. So first I'm just taking this Illegal concealer, and on the left side I'm going to go in with directly this concealer, and I'll show you how it looks. So I want to color correct around the eye, so I'm just going to take this directly and apply it as such. And I'm just going to take a brush and I'm going to blend that in. So this is how I color corrected on my left side. Directly just went in with a bright orange. Now on the right side, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just normally take a concealer which has like matches my skin and has a little of orange tone. This is something I normally do in all my videos. You have seen this before, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to show you how you can use your normal concealer with a color corrector. I'm going to take this concealer which matches my skin tone, at least almost matches my skin tone, and I took a little bit of orange on my panel. So I am just going to add a little bit of this concealer as well onto that. So I just added the concealer which is my skin tone onto that as well. So now, unlike this side, what I'm going to do for this side is I am going to just take a tiny bit of orange and mix it with my concealer. So now what happens is I'm just going to get a touch of orange, a touch of warmth in that concealer. Now, which is more than enough to correct my dark circle. Then I actually postponed this video a lot because I wanted to demonstrate this on somebody who has deeper skin tone, has a lot of discoloration. But now it's been 3 months since the lockdown. I don't know when I'll get the opportunity, and you guys really want to see it, so I'm just demonstrating it on me. Now for me, I don't have really, you know, have that much of a dark circle, and even if you do, this will be more than enough. Just according to your dark circles, the amount of orange. Now I'm just going to take that and apply it in the area and blend it. Now I can get away with not correcting my skin as well, like it doesn't really matter because like I don't have that major like discoloration. But yeah, I do like to do it sometimes if I want to go in very thin layers, and if I don't want to use anything full coverage, then I do color correct so that I can just go in with something which is a very thin layer, like a sheer product, and I can, you know, be done with it. Orange is a very, very bright color, especially the LA Girl one. I'm demonstrating that because I know a lot of people have the LA Girl concealer. So it's a very, very bright orange. I'll tell you, this is like the shade is just called Orange Corrector. So you just have need a tiny bit, like just a touch on that, and then mix it with concealer, or else again it's going to be like too much dark. So just take a light layer. You don't get used to it once you try doing it 3-4 times. You'll understand how much you need it. So just go in with small light layers. Now after that, if you think you need more, then only add. Just go in with light layers, keep building it. Don't go in with too much of something and then try to fix it. Okay, now you can see the difference between this side and this side, right? So this completely got color corrected with a little of orange, and this is like too bright orange. Now both of these seem fine, like nothing wrong. Both of them did color correct, both of them did cancel out the darkness. But now you'll understand why I like this side over this side. So I'm just going to take my concealer and I'm just going to add a little bit here and a little bit here. Now that's how I usually conceal as well. So I'm just going to add it here and here. Now that is enough. Now I'm just going to do the same thing here as well. I'm just going to add it here and here. Now we're going to blend both of these and see how it looks. So now that was more than enough on this side. Now because I added such a bright orange on the other side, I have to take more product to cover that orange and create a beautiful layer on top. Now I took twice the size amount of product I took on my right side to cover this up. Now after adding so much product, you can see that this got covered. But always adding so much product is never ideal because you don't want your face to look very cakey. That's the difference between using a normal warm concealer on the skin and versus using a very bright orange concealer. I'll just add a thin layer of foundation and I'll be right back. Now on camera, this side looks perfectly fine, but in real life, I can see that this side is quite heavy compared to this side. And I did add a foundation. I ordered a L'Oreal Infallible. It's like a medium sheer coverage foundation. If I do use a full coverage, then I don't need to color correct. But if I go in with something sheer medium, I do feel like I need to color correct a tiny bit around the mouth. It's fine if you don't do it. You don't can't see so much, but right here you can see I have a little bit of discoloration going on, so that is something I usually color correct. Now color correcting under the foundation is ideal, you can definitely do that, but just for the sake of demonstration, I'm doing it on top of my foundation in case you want to color correct after applying foundation. If you think there's some gray tones going on, if you want to color correct after foundation, then this is how you can do it. Now I'm just going to normally do what I usually do, that is I take a shade which is it has a little warm tones, and I'm going to apply it wherever I think I need it. So I'm just going to apply it there because this is the area where I have that gray tones, and little around the nose. This is fine, I can blend it off and it looks really seamless. It looks like something which matches my skin. I would advise doing color correction under the foundation because once you apply the foundation, everything will get evened out. You can definitely do this after also, so I'm just showing you how to do it. So I just color corrected it. Now what I can do is I can just take a tiny bit of foundation, like a touch of foundation, and I can go over it and it will get covered and everything will look nice and even. So everything looks nice and even, nothing is too heavy, nothing is too cakey, everything looks really nice. But if I'm going to go in with this bright orange on my concealer, so I'm too scared to even apply it. Now if I'm going to go with this bright orange on the mouth, I'm just going to apply a tiny bit, even because that you can see right how much I applied, even that is going to be too much. I'm going to show you. So I'm just going to take that and blend it around the mouth. You can definitely see there's a lot of orange going on, which is not ideal. You don't want to look orange, you just want everything to look very cancelled out. So again, not a good step, because again you have to add a lot of foundation for it to get covered compared to the other side. So if you're thinking that you are really deep skin tone and you have a lot worse discoloration than I have, this trick wouldn't work. Don't worry, it does work, because this is what I've been doing on my brides as well. I've worked on some really deep skin tone brides who have really major discoloration, but this trick works beautifully. Just take the foundation or a concealer which matches your skin tone, add a tiny bit of orange, give that warmth to the product, and then apply it. That will cancel it out, and then you can go on top of it with whatever foundation or concealer which you normally wear, and everything is going to look really evened out. And one more thing is, don't do it if it's not necessary. A lot of people ask me why I don't color correct in all my videos. I'm like, it's not really necessary. I can really cover everything with just using my product, so why add a layer of color correcting when it is really not necessary? So if you're using a foundation which is very full coverage and you don't think you need it, then simply don't color correct. But this video is just for somebody who has to do it, so that is there. So always, if you have really major discoloration, always correct your skin. So those were my few points. I'll just finish the rest of my face and I'll be right back. So yeah, I'm back, and so I just want to add a couple more points. Compared to this side and this side, everything looks flawless on camera. Everything looks nice and even. Yes, everything looks nice and even. You don't see any discoloration on this side, you don't see any discoloration on this side, but this side is quite heavy compared to this side because there's a lot of product on this side. side, and I do feel like, you know, I'm wearing a lot of makeup on my left side. Like my under eye feels a little dry and stuff. So you can do both of the things, but it's always ideal to do what is right so that you can add lesser product, you can get a more natural finish and more, you know, less cakier finish, if that makes sense. So now all that is fine, but if in case you have a color corrector which is extremely sheer, just adds a touch of orange, then you can completely go ahead with it and then you know, use a normal concealer, completely fine. But mostly 60-70% of the correctors are extremely bright, so that's the reason I showed you this technique, that you can mix it with your concealer or foundation. But if it's sheer, totally fine, you can go in with it directly, or even with this concealer you can add a very tiny bit. Sometimes that can also be done, so I'll just show you. I'm just taking my fan, just adding that much, that is more than enough, like for your you know, entire under eye. You can blend it out, you can blend it out and diffuse it as much as you can. Tone it down as much as you can, get down the orange. You can see that even that tiny amount of orange gave me so much of, like, you know, orange coverage. So yeah, just be mindful of how much you use, because a little goes a really long way, and if you use too much, then again you have to use something else to compensate it. That's like a whole messy thing, you don't want to do it. That was my take on color correcting. So if you have major discoloration, always color correct before going in with your foundation or concealer, because you want to avoid those gray tones coming from beneath. So yeah, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. And yeah, like, you know, please like, share, subscribe to my channel, and ring the notification bell. It'll be in the world to me, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.